Today we're talking about the new $16 billion farm aid program that the White House just announced. Now, I know that at this point, if I hear any number over maybe $1 million, my brain just defaults to, wow, that's more money than I'll ever own. The government is spending an unachievable amount of money rebuilding this stadium, and an even more unachievable amount of money giving democracy to this country. $16 billion is on the larger side of the unachievable spectrum. I mean, we shut down the government for a record amount of time for $5.7 billion. But $16 billion? Eh, go right ahead. This is almost twice the EPA's $8.8 billion budget. I'm not saying that this aid program is good or bad, I'm just saying that's a ton of money. With that, what did we commit to spending $16 billion on?
Republican backlash is growing against President Trump's $12 billion plan to help American farmers feeling the pain of the escalating trade war.
No, Stephen, that's the $12 billion bailout from 10 months ago. Now we're piling on an additional $16 billion on top of that. Man, when I heard that there was a lot of pork in the 2019 budget, I didn't think this was what people were talking about. So to this bailout that was just announced, what is it? Well, the program includes $14.5 billion in direct payment to producers, $1.4 billion in government purchases to be distributed through school lunch programs and local food banks, and the USDA also allocated $100 million for export promotion. Ooh, $100 million in export promotion, that should really cancel out the trade war. Before we go into the details on this one, what is going on here on a basic level? Because, as one Fox News anchor points out, well, this doesn't look great.
Is it difficult to defend a policy where you have, you know, higher taxes put in place, which is what tariffs really are, then the retaliation for that hurts people in this country, and then a bailout, which is essentially what this has been, is put in place to help those people who are hurt? I mean, what would you say if it was a Democratic administration doing that kind of thing?
The question I'm going to try to answer today is, essentially, what is happening? Because, really, what is happening? The government is paying farmers billions of dollars to plant crops that, because of the trade war, have no demand. The big worry is, as chief commodities economist at Brokerage points out, the USDA is getting creative to avoid impacting planting decisions. The bottom line from a market standpoint is that it removes the link between planting decisions and the aid package. It focuses the markets back on weather problems. So that's the goal, avoid influencing what farmers plant. This is something we've learned from the previous $12 billion round of farm aid, where our strategy was, we're going to be giving disproportionately to soybean and corn producers. But oh man, please don't produce soybeans or corn, because the only reason we're supplementing their income is nobody wants their product, so the price is bottoming out. The new strategy of removing the link between planting decisions and aid has some concerned, and some hopeful. And, well, to sum it up in one sentence without context wouldn't do it justice at all. The basic worry is...
There was some concern that some of this aid package might, in fact, steer farmers to planting crops that they wouldn't have otherwise planted.
And this has been addressed in what's probably a less fair yet much smarter distribution method than our strategy from 10 months ago. Perdue said that the USDA has redesigned last year's aid program of up to $12 billion based on feedback. The new program, therefore, will have a single payment per county calculated by damages in that area, instead of a rate for every commodity across the nation. Well, we could have funded the EPA for a year and a half, but look at all these soybeans we grew. Some vegetarian out there just found a new fantasy. Credit where credit's due, this is an objectively better idea than the last round, where, in a policy of Soviet levels of efficiency, we were paying farmers to grow crops that were so unwanted that storage was overflowing. That was a fun little $12 billion mistake. Now, and I realize I'm notoriously sarcastic, but in this case I'm being straight with you, the system is improved because we're now indiscriminately paying farmers from districts that lost money from previous year crop miscalculations, affected by a trade war that they were surprised by. This means that they can recoup their losses and actually produce things that will sell. The problem now is a similar but smaller issue.
They're pushed now by weather as those final crop insurance dates are quickly approaching. And I will add that, William, this new assistance package that was released today, folks, if you do not plant acres, if those acres do not get planted, they will not be eligible for the assistance package that President Trump and the USDA announced today.
I mean, makes sense. We don't want to pay people for not growing stuff. I've been not growing stuff pro bono for my entire life. The worry is, well, this year hasn't been kind to farmland.
Record-breaking late winter floods have led to statewide emergency declarations in Mississippi, Missouri, Nebraska, and Wisconsin.
That was 2 months ago, and well, you better figure out some way to plant something if you want to qualify for this aid program. The details of this program were released on the 23rd, and the final plant deadlines for most crops are coming up in the next week or two, depending on region and crop. Don't worry though, soy crops have the last deadlines, so if you're late to the game, you can get paid by the government to plant a worthless crop. I'm going to use Bloomberg as a source for this next part because I don't really interact with a ton of farmers from my small Queens apartment, besides the guy upstairs who 50-50 chance he's growing something up there. After heavy rains and flooding in the American heartland this spring, farmers were expected to discontinue their planting plans. Speculation was mounting that growers would instead opt to make claims for so-called prevented plant insurance. Then this announcement happened and, well, now farmers have about a week to figure out whether they want to collect insurance or government aid. As Bloomberg again reports, the main criticism we have right now is that we have a natural-born situation where you could blame Mother Nature and abandon additional planting. Here we're subsidizing farmers to continue to produce what we already have too much of. Great, so we're still dabbling in the free market to get people to make stuff that nobody wants, but now it's on broader terms. The essential argument here is that let them collect on the crop insurance they bought if they don't think they can make money on crops, and let them grow crops if they think they can sell them. Of course, the problem with this is
they're looking for other markets, but no one is buying enough as much soybeans as China is. And so, sure, government support, I think, helps, but farmers, I think, view this as something of a band-aid.
Yes, by far our largest customer stopped buying these soybeans, so demand has sunk far below supply. This means the price has bottomed out and farmers are selling their crops at a loss. Because I know it's America, but even we look at those massive piles of soybeans and corn and say, whoo-wee, I'm full. The government, in an attempt to keep farmers afloat, is slapping the invisible hands, presumably also invisible wrist, and saying, keep making all of this excess food at a loss, and we'll cover the difference until we can figure out who's gonna buy all this. Because of this, we're seeing one other potential side problem that is emerging. This behavior was one of the main things the Chinese government did to trigger the trade war in the first place. Hey, if you can't beat 'em, join 'em.
Last week, the U.S. said imports of Chinese stainless steel products are being sent in at below market value. Now, China's Ministry of Commerce released a statement after the U.S. announced anti-dumping and anti-subsidy duties on Chinese stainless steel coming into the U.S.
Yeah, if you're a government and you're paying businesses to make so much of something at a loss that you're literally, and this is an economics term, dumping them on other countries to get it off your inventory, well, that's frowned upon. The U.S. Soybean Export Council, man, we'll really make a council for anything, released a statement saying that this new model for this round of subsidies avoids providing an incentive to plant soybeans to get a big payment. It is a decoupled payment, so that should avoid any WTO problems. So these subsidies are just vague enough that we're legally covered. Still though, the larger question remains, what the heck are we gonna do with all this food? I mean, this is a China-sized collection of food that just fell into our laps. Because of the previous set of government incentives, this fall America harvested more soybeans than ever, and nobody wants them. Well, do your patriotic duty and buy some tofu. Or maybe try 10 Impossible Burgers. Or what the heck, just put soybeans in your blender and chug that stuff. Have a soybean fight at your local park. plant them and see if that forms a magic beanstalk that'll get you some gold. Just please, please, please buy some damn soybeans before Trump's 2020 budget looks like a Whole Foods shopping list. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hello YouTube, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to support independent, nonpartisan news, remember to subscribe by clicking on this floating logo to the left of my head. Ring that bell so that freedom will continue to ring, and give me a thumbs up if you like what you saw. Lastly, as always, thank you for watching.